challenge is over. A month ago, I challenged you, my employees, and myself to get a Juniper IT certification in 30 days. Did you pass?
Did I pass?
You thought I was gonna tell you right here? Nah, you gotta wait until the end of the video after you like and comment and subscribe. And we're also going to announce the winner of the missed AP. So don't miss that. But before we do that, let me first start with this. Why did I do this challenge? Because like many of you, I already know a bit of networking, like I have my CCNA. Isn't that enough? Why get another networking certification from a different vendor? Cheat code. That's why. This is a cheat code for your IT career, opening doors to some crazy things and some insane opportunities. Now, I have two reasons why this is a cheat code. Reason number one, you wanna go broad. You wanna go wide in your technical knowledge and expertise. When I first started my IT career, I only had to learn one vendor, one thing. And in my case, that was Cisco. The company I worked for was a Cisco shop, and that's all they had: Cisco firewalls, APs, switches, routers, everything. And frankly, it was awesome. I was a Cisco fanboy, and if anybody tried to put anything but Cisco in my environment, no, get that out of here. That's not the case anymore. You'll be hard pressed to find any company that just has one vendor, one tech stack in their environment. So what you'll see now is just a delicious buffet of different vendors and technologies. Companies will pick and choose their favorite vendors for the specific use cases they have, and it's kind of cool. But what that means for you is that it's not enough to know just one vendor anymore. You gotta be familiar with multiple and know how to configure those things. In fact, if you look at most job requirements now, they'll tell you what they have, and they're gonna have Cisco, they're gonna have Juniper, they're gonna have Palo Alto, they're gonna have a bunch of different things, and they're gonna ask you to know those things, like, hey, do you have experience? Do you have a JNCIA? They want you to have that. You're like, Chuck, why do I need to get a certification? I can just learn the stuff, right? I can figure it out, I can Google it, I can watch a YouTube video, and that's true. You don't need the IT certifications, but maybe. A certification will really help you out when you need to learn the ins and outs of a certain technology or a vendor. You wanna learn more about what it can do, and also how to do it right. I can't tell you how many times I've been working with a technology that I didn't have a certification in, and then I finally decided, okay, I wanna learn more. I wanna get that certification. Dude, I was doing it totally wrong. And I learned a lot more things about it and how I could do things better. It really does help. And also, if you're having trouble finding a job, getting these certifications that maybe aren't as popular, but we know people are using their stuff, it's gonna help you. So if you're wondering, well, Chuck, will it matter if I have a CCNA and a JNCIA? Will that help? Yeah, it will help. It will complement what you already know and open up a ton of opportunities. Now, you're gonna think I'm crazy, like Chuck's lost it, because the second reason is the opposite of the first reason. Number two, I want you to go deep. I want you to specialize. But this right here is where the opportunity arises to make a ton more money. Because here's what I've learned in my career. If you wanna make more money in IT and be more valuable to the company you're at, you need to acquire skills that not everyone has. Skills that are a bit more rare, harder to find. So whatever skill you're thinking about, could be hacking or system administration, cloud, but let's use networking for example. If you want to learn networking, everybody knows, okay, Network Plus or CCNA, like that's the go-to thing. But you can set yourself apart, make yourself a bit more rare by getting something like the JNCIA with your CCNA. But don't stop there, because right here is the secret to how you can kind of multiply your worth and your value. Don't stop at JNCIA. Take that next step. Choose rare skills. So let me show you real quick. If I go out to juniper.net/networkchuck, once you've brought in your skill set with a base cert, JNCIA Junos, you then could take the next step into doing a more rare skill. For example, maybe the Mist AI, which is some crazy wireless automation voodoo magic. It's awesome. And if you know that, you are magical, you're a magician. You're welcome. Now I gotta be honest, if you do a job search for people looking for the JNCIA Mist AI certification, it's not gonna be a lot. But let me tell you a secret. That means that the jobs who actually do need those skills, they're gonna pay you more for them. You're rare. This will set you apart, make you more valuable, and open up a ton of opportunity. So you may be here at the end of our 30-day challenge, and maybe you have a new certification, the JNCIA, which is awesome. Congrats, you did amazing. But for next steps, if you wanted to make yourself more rare, you might jump to something like the Mist AI and maybe go beyond that. Jump beyond the associate level and go to the specialist, the JNCIS, which is even more rare. And that's where some cool opportunities might arise. For example, there's a guy in my Discord, the Packet Thrower. You probably know who he is. We've had him on the channel a few times. We did a live stream just last week, but he actually works at Disney and he used his Juniper skills to get there. Now, what I'm not saying is, yeah, if you learn Juniper, you'll get a job at Disney. Maybe, I don't know, it's worth a try, right? But what I am saying is that rare skills will open up rare opportunities. So let me sum this up before I tell you if I pass or fail the exam. Quick coffee break on that. So IT certifications, getting the popular top 10 list IT certs is valuable and fine. I'm sure you'll Google that list, right? And you'll see the top 10, you're like, oh, I've gotta get all of those, right? But let me tell you, it's often the road less traveled. The other certs, the ones you wouldn't automatically think about. Those are the cheat codes to an amazing career in IT. So the takeaway here is go crazy, go broad. Expose yourself to other vendors and certifications in IT. Chuck, how can I possibly learn all these things? I'm just trying to learn Cisco. You expect me now to learn Juniper too? And I want to tell you, it's honestly not that hard. For example, Cameron and I, this challenge, 30 days getting the JNCIA, wasn't that hard because we already have our CCNA. And getting the JNCIA was a complementary skill. It was simply just kind of like an add-on to the foundational skills we built. So honestly, the hardest part in your IT journey is learning the base foundational skills, good networking, good security, Linux, Windows, all those base things. That's the hard part. But adding the additional skills on top that rely on those underlying skills, it's a bit easier. And the more you do it, the easier it'll get, and then the easier it is to broaden your skills. And of course, if you want to help make the next Marvel movie, level up, go deep, specialize, and that will open up some crazy doors. So let's talk about the 30-day challenge. Did I pass the exam? Yeah, I passed. Did I have to study a lot? Not really, no. Because of the points I mentioned before, I was already good on most networking things. It was just learning how to do those networking things on Juniper devices. Did Cameron pass? Yeah, he passed. He did too. That's my point, right? Coffee break. And by the way, you would have already known that I passed if you follow me on Twitter, Insta, Facebook, and all those other places. Make sure you follow me there. Go check it out, link below. Now, I'm sure you're wondering, how did the non-techies on my team do? Because as part of the challenge, I did challenge my employees, the people who know nothing about IT, to get the certification. They had a hard time. In fact, they quit. Because, like I said, you have to have a large, fundamental, foundational knowledge of networking and IT in general to jump to something like this. That's a lot for 30 days. Totally possible, by the way. You can do it. But I wasn't going to pay my employees 8 hours a day to study. So, but I would love to know, if you were a person who had no IT background, or maybe just a little bit, if you were able to get the JNCIA, let me know. That's kind of incredible. And I know that many of you just killed the challenge. You got it. You got the JNCIA, or maybe some of you even got the JNCIS, which also means you're gonna get this wicked awesome sticker right here for passing the challenge. Now, I do want to say this. We did make a few changes to the challenge, because I know for a lot of people, paying for a certification, it's expensive. So we did this. We had the packet thrower, actually, the guy I just mentioned who works at Disney. We had him create a really awesome quiz to test your knowledge of Juniper stuff. And if you can pass that quiz, if you can verify that knowledge, we'll give you a sticker. So we'll have all that information below. Check it out. And yes, there is still time to enter this and try to get a sticker. So just check the link below. If you pass it, bam, you'll get one. And now for the winner of the missed AP, Cameron. Take it away.
Thanks, Chuck. The winner of the Juniper Missed AP is going to be Robert Seeley from North Carolina. Congratulations, Robert.